Have you ever had a really bad day and think the whole universe is against you? Here's the good news. The universe likely couldn't care less about you because Cosmo is indifferent. But wait, it gets even better. There's a thing called the Anthropic Shadow, which basically says we are just lucky to be alive because we have dodged all the cosmic disaster by chance. It's like the universe has been playing an epic game of dodgeball and we are somehow still standing. And then there is the Fermi Paradox, asking why we haven't bumped into any aliens yet. Maybe they are just avoiding us like we are the weirdo of the universe block party. Anyway, I don't know about you, but this three concept actually gave me quite a bit of existential dread. So let's talk about them one by one. Okay, let's start with the first one. One, anthropic shadow. Imagine you are in a dark room playing hide and seek, and you have found what you think is a really good spot. You start to think this spot is so good that no one can ever find you. But in reality, the only reason that no one has found you yet is just that they haven't, and they will. That is anthropic shadow, kind of. We are all here alive, living our life, because we have managed to avoid the big bad events that could have wiped us out. But just because we have been lucky so far doesn't mean these scary things aren't out there. The concept of anthropic shadow is a critical and soul-provoking idea introduced by Nick Bostrom. It refers to an observation selection effect that skews our understanding of catastrophic events, frequency, and severity. Essentially, it suggests that humanity's current existence imposes a bias on our ability to observe and evaluate the true likelihood of existential or a catastrophic event. To understand this concept, I think it will be helpful to talk about what the term anthropic means. The term anthropic comes from Greek word anthropos, means human. It is often used in philosophical and scientific discussion to refer to anything related to human beings or the human condition. In broader context, it's also related to the observation and understanding of the universe from a human-centered perspective. This concept is fundamental in various discussions, including the anthropic principle, which argues that the universe's law and constant appear finally to support life, because only a universe capable of eventually supporting observers, like humans, would be observed in the first place. This principle highlights the interconnectedness between the existence of observers and the type of universe they find themselves in. This effect suggests that humans might underestimate the frequency of catastrophic events capable of wiping out human lives because, by necessity, humans have not observed such an event. They wouldn't be here to make the observation if such an event had occurred in their vicinity or during their existence. The anthropic shadow can apply to various scales and types of catastrophic event, from asteroid impact to volcano eruptions, pandemic, or even broader cosmological phenomena like the collapse of vacuum state, gamma ray burst, and nearby supernova explosions. Each of these phenomena represent a significant, though very existential threat to life on Earth. Since these events are, by their nature, capable of eliminating observers, there is a building bias in the data humans can collect about them. The anthropic shadow has significant implications for the assessment of human extinction's risk and suggests directions for future research into understanding these biases and their impact on the estimating catastrophic risk. The concept of the anthropic shadow raises existential concern by pointing out our blind spot to potential extinction-level events. The reasoning behind it suggests we might be living in a misleading safe period, a shadow, because we have not yet encountered, nor could we observe, events that could wipe out human existence. This perspective induces a kind of existential dread by highlighting the twofold ignorance. Not only are we unaware of the true frequencies of this catastrophic event, but our very existence might be contingent on the improbable absence of such events in our recent past. It's akin to walking through a minefield, blindfolded, blissfully unaware of the danger we have likely avoided so far. This can lead to a false sense of security about the future and perhaps a failure to take adequate precautions against existential threat that has not yet occurred but might be overdue. Moreover, the anthropic shadow contributes to existential dread by making us question the stability and longevity of our existence in the cosmos. The idea that our survival might hinge on sheer luck or rare condition rather than robust safety from existential threat can be deeply unsettling. It challenges the assumption that humanity will continue to progress or even survive in the long term, injecting a note of fragility and precariousness into our conception of human destiny. This existential dread stirred by Anthropic Shadow is not just about the fear of unknown threat. It's also about the realization of our limitation in understanding and preparing for this threat. It confronts us with the profound uncertainty of our place in the universe, suggesting that our continued existence may depend more on chance than on our ability to control or even perceive the risk we are facing. Two Fermi paradox and the gray filter. The Fermi paradox is named after physicist Enrico Fermi and highlights the contradiction between the high probability of extraterrestrial life existing in the universe given the vast number of stars and planets and complete lack of evidence for such civilizations. In 1950s, Fermi famously questioned, "Where is everybody?" reflecting on why if the universe is teeming with life, we have not yet encountered any signs of it. The Great Filter Theories offers a potential resolution to the Fermi paradox. It suggests that there is a significant barrier or set of barriers in developing of life from its simplest form to becoming a technologically advanced civilization capable of interstellar communication or travel. This filter could be so insurmountable that it prevents civilization from reaching a state where they can make their presence known across the cosmos. The great filter could be behind us, suggesting humanity has already passed the most significant hurdle to existence. Alternatively, it might still lie ahead, posing unknown challenges that could prevent us from advancing further or even lead to our extinction. Several stages have been proposed as potential points for the Great Filter, ranging from the emergence of life from non-life, abiogenesis, the development of multicellular life, the rise of technological advanced civilization, to the ability of such civilization to avoid self-destruction. The exact nature of Great Filter remains speculative, with hypotheses including the rarity of life emergence, the difficulty of transition to multicellular organisms, or self-destructive tendency of advanced civilization. Astrobiology research and the research for technosignature or biosignature continue to refine our understanding of where the Great Filter might lie. If evidence of simple life form is found to be common in the galaxy, but technosignature are rare, it could indicate that the Great Filter lies in the development of technological civilization rather than the emergence of life itself. The implications of Great Filter are profound. If the filter is behind us, it suggests that humanity is among the rare instances of life that have successfully navigated the most significant challenges to existence. If it lies ahead, it could mean that the development of advanced spacefaring civilization is exceedingly rare, possibly due to inherent self-destructive tendency or insurmountable technological challenges. 3. Cosmic indifference. Cosmic indifference, closely related to the concept of cosmicism, is a literary and philosophical idea most prominently associated with the work of American writer H.P. Lovecraft. This concept posits that the universe is vast, ancient, and indifferent to the existence of humanity. It suggests that humans' achievements, struggles, and emotions are ultimately meaningless when viewed against the backdrop of the cosmos. Lovecraft's story often feature a cosmic entity that exists beyond human comprehension, neither good nor evil, existing in a realm of indifference towards humanity. This makes human endeavor seem trivial and insignificant in the grand scheme of the universe. Cosmicism has influenced not only literature, but also modern pop culture and philosophy, evolving beyond Lovecraft's original works. It is recognized as an influential movement, impacting author, filmmaker, and game developer who continue to explore the theme of cosmic indifference and the incomprehensible nature of the universe. The core principle of cosmicism include the vast and indifferent universe, incomprehensible cosmic entity, and the human fear of the unknown. This idea challenged our human-centric worldview and encouraged a re-evaluation of our place within the cosmos. Moreover, cosmicism shared philosophical ground with nihilism and existentialism in that it questioned the significance of human existence and achievement in the face of an indifferent cosmos. It offers a perspective that contrasts sharply with traditional human-centric views and conventional religious beliefs, promoting a humbler view of humanity's place in the universe. This exploration of cosmic indifference and cosmicism reveals a philosophical stance that underscores the insignificance of human concern in the face of the cosmos' vast, indifferent expanse. It invites reflection on our understanding of existence, our quest for meaning, and how we relate to the universe at large. So here you go. If you want to learn more about the topic I shared today, you can check out the further reading list in the description. And if you want to learn more random knowledge, please subscribe. I'm Shel from What People Also Ask. See you next time!